From the Hill of Crosses
to the craziest stuff found in Japan.
These are
the five weirdest places.
Five!
Located not too far away from the town of Šiauliai in northern Lithuania, you'll come across one of their most well-known landmarks, but it's still kind of strange. It might look like an overcrowded cemetery, but it's not. Crosses were placed here in honor of independence fighters, and under the rule of the Soviet Union, it became a symbol of peaceful defiance. Many of the crosses are quite unique, and every size, shape, and design is a little bit different. In modern times, anyone finding a need to commemorate something close to them will choose to place a cross here. There's believed to be over 200,000 different crosses scattered on this sacred hill for various reasons, but they've kinda lost count. The hill itself holds some historical value to it even before the appearance of the crosses. It was once the location of a Lithuanian fort that was destroyed. Family members came here to place crosses if their loved ones were not found after battle. Doing something like this was still considered to be illegal under Soviet occupation, since all major religions were banned. In 1961, over 5,000 crosses were destroyed by the Soviets, but they were quickly replaced. The number of crosses here continued to grow in the 20th century in order to express desire for Lithuanian independence. The country of Lithuania primarily identifies with the Catholic religion, and even Pope John Paul visited this place in 1993. He described it as a place of peace, hope, sacrifice, and love. With everyone trying to get their cross placed on the hill, the density of the crosses became overwhelming, and that's what makes this place unique. Who knows how many crosses will be here in the future as the popularity of the site continues to grow. Eventually, the Soviets would give up on trying to destroy this peaceful form of defiance, and in 1991, Lithuania finally gained their independence. Now, as an independent country, Lithuania can place as many crosses as they want to.
Four!
Officially, Area 51 is a United States military base. It functions as a testing facility that develops experimental weapons and technologically advanced aircrafts. But that's not what this underground base is famous for. This sketchy operation is located in the dry desert sands of Nevada. Don't bother looking on a map. You won't find anything. Don't think about flying a drone over this place. The airspace is heavily guarded. The government denied the existence of Area 51 until 2013. What made this base famous was the 1947 Roswell incident. In other words, aliens. Whether fact or fiction, no one can deny the weirdness that comes from Area 51.
Three!
On the southern coast of Peru lies a city and systems of valleys known as the Nazca Province. The name is derived from the ancient culture of people known as the Nazca. What's so weird about that, you ask? Well, nothing really. Which brings us to the Nazca Lines. In 1939, a pilot was flying over the Peruvian desert in the Nazca Province when he looked down to discover hundreds of strange drawings in the sand. There were animals, plants, and strange geometric patterns. In total, there were 800 straight lines carved into the dry rock. Several researchers believe that these straight lines have astronomical purposes. Others insist that these lines were part of rain dance rituals. And of course, the famous conspiracy. Some people believe that aliens communicated with the Nazca people through the lines. Whatever the truth is, we can all agree that this place is seriously weird.
Two!
What isn't gloriously weird about Japan? Even the other itty-bitty islands which surround this island nation are incredibly bizarre. One has thousands of feral kitty cats. Another is dominated by thousands of feral rabbits. The island of gas masks has a volcano which constantly leaks poisonous gases. And a few unsavory islands have been abandoned completely, and the rumors say they are cursed, haunted, and really creepy. In the mood for some weird food, there's the bunny cafe, kitty cat bars, themed restaurants, poisonous blowfish, toilet cafes, cuddle cafes, and the most unique snack foods ever. You could have some Mountain Dew Cheetos and wash it down with some eel soda. Yum. Fashion trends in the land of the rising sun are cray cray. There's Decora Pop, Genderless Kai, Fairy Kai, Uneven Snaggletooth, and even something with bugs in your hair. They've got fish tank aquarium toilets, baby mop outfits, people pillows, Dutch wives, voluptuous mouse pads, sushi bazooka guns, and Hello Kitty everything! If you can dream it, Japan is probably hard at work selling it. Probably, conveniently, in a vending machine. Available on nearly every street corner, pop in a few coins and get ready for anything that your stomach, liver, or libido could ever desire. In Japan, Napping on the job and slurping noodles are noble traits. Arcades are stadium-sized. Hotels are capsule-sized. Forests can be suicidal, and cats can be made station master. Word is, the cat rules Wakayama Station with an iron paw. So, the land of the rising sun is weird as it gets.
One!
The Mir space station was in low Earth orbit from 1986 to 2001. In that time, it functioned a lot like people's first cars. Despite plenty of malfunctions and faulty components, it did just enough to get the job done. Remarkably, it never got anyone killed or seriously injured, and it lasted a lot longer than anyone expected. Its operators, first the Soviet Union and then the Russians, definitely did their part to run it into the ground. 104 people called the precarious station home in its 15-year lifespan, including Valery Polyakov, who spent nearly 438 days on Mir, earning him the record for the longest single human stay in space. By 1991, there were so many electrical problems that lights kept on going out. In 1994, a departing craft bumped into one of the station modules twice. British-American astronaut Michael Foll stayed on Mir for 4 months and compared it to a frat house with slightly more organization. 1997 was the beginning of the end for Mir. In February, flames broke out after a cosmonaut ignited a faulty oxygen-generating canister. The fire lasted 15 minutes and covered the station in smoky ash and debris. In June, a resupply craft crashed headlong into the Spectre module. The accident was the worst space collision in history. Despite all of this, the crew that was manning the station celebrated Christmas that year and appeared to have a good time. At that point, they were probably happy with the fact that they were still alive. It's also likely that they dipped into Mir's supply of cognac and vodka. By the turn of the millennium, the station was in a disgusting state. Dirty, brownish water globules the size of basketballs floated around the station unchecked. It carried a stench comparable to an overused, underwashed jockstrap. Funding was cut, and the station was deorbited before crashing into the ocean in 2001. Despite its scruffy and often dangerous nature, Mir was an important stepping stone in humankind's exploration of space. It was the first continuously inhabited orbital outpost in human history. It paved the way for the International Space Station, which floats in low Earth orbit today. Several countries collaborated with the Russians to both use and add to Mir. In the turbulent times in which it existed, it came to symbolize the power of peace between nations of the world. So those were five of the weirdest places on Earth. Do you think you're prepared for 12 of the scariest? Check out this video, and we'll see you next time.